month on new discoveries. So, though I'm a faculty in Kitt School of Management, but I was associated with MAC since 2005. So I worked there for more than 14 years. So I, before proceeding, I have three requests for successful completion of this webinar. So I hope all of you will keep my request. The first one, all of you, please keep your audio and video video off, and please mute your audio so that the webinar can be conducted successfully. And the second request, all those who have joined, please be in the webinar from the beginning till end, so that we can have mutual learning. And the third one, if you have any questions to ask, please note down and you can write in the chat box. So at the end, we can take few questions. So these are three requests to all the participants present here. So I hope all of you will keep my request. So now, before proceeding, let me speak a few words about the organization which is organizing these webinars as a part of adding value to human life. So MAC Group of Institutions is an organization which adds the main objective or the main motto is to add value in human life, and it consists of four organizations. The parent organization, Manav Adhyayan Kendra, which started in the year 2001, is dedicated for adding value to human life. It conducts different kinds of training program and like soft skill trainings and technical trainings in different corporates. It also conducts open house training programs, motivational talks, and personality development programs for different audience. The Manav Adhyayan Kendra has covered more than 150 organizations, and it operated across the country, that is more than 25 states. And the second organization, MAC Consultancy Services, which started in the year 2013, provides holistic HR consultancy services in different domains like HR audit, OD intervention, HR manual preparation, core HR practical trainings, etc. So MAC Consultancy Services has also carried out different HR audit study and prepared HR manuals for different organizations, conducted many batches of core HR practical trainings. And the third one, MAC Placement Services, which also deals with, which started in the year 2013 and which deals with manpower recruitment and placement. And the last one, MAC Public School, which is a new addition to our group of institutions, which is meant for value education for the students. And the objective is to give value education to students from UK, from LKG to intermediate degrees. So, but all these four organizations, the basic purpose is to add value in human life. So MAC Group of Institutions also bagged two valuable projects into its credit. Like one is the Vyaktitva Vikas training program, which is being conducted by MAC Group of Institutions for the underprivileged students who in free of cost. Like for those students who stays in slum areas, orphanage, tribal hostels and sheltered homes, etc. And another important project is being carried out by MAC Group of Institutions, which is for the senior citizens of the country. The project name is Sanjog, so which is created to explore and express the creativity of the senior citizens. And as all of you know that because in this busy life schedule, the senior citizens are staying alone because most of their children are settled outside or not staying with them because of the busy life schedule. So to have an association and to explore and express their creativity, Sanjog has been created. So these are the two prestigious projects which has been carried out by MAC Group of Institutions. So this is all about my organization, and I'm very happy to be a part of the organization which always adds value to human life through different forms. So now, now let me introduce the eminent speaker for this webinar. So it's my honor and pride privilege to introduce the esteemed speaker, Mr. Mohesh Sandeepan Gaikwad. Sir, I welcome on behalf of MAC Group of Institutions, I welcome you to this webinar, and once again, namaskar. So let me speak a few words about sir. Presently he is working as a deputy manager in the area of health, safety and construction in Sapurji Palonji Engineering and Construction, situated in Mumbai. And he, being a spiritual soul, he is serving as a volunteer in Ramkrishna Matha, Pune. He owned multiple of diploma degrees into his account, such as diploma in electrical engineering, diploma in industrial safety, and advanced diploma in energy management and audit, etc. He bagged more than 20 years of experiences to his credit in India and abroad in the field of construction, health, safety, and environment. I welcome you, sir, to this webinar. Definitely, you will enrich our knowledge on Swami Vivekananda, because Swami Vivekananda is a legend who had shown different paths and builds our Indian culture. And all of you must agree that Swami Vivekananda is a legend who has taught us how to live life to the fullest and how to get detached from everything. So I don't want to speak much on the topic because sir is there. So I welcome you, sir. Now I'm handing over the session to you, sir. Please take forward the webinar. Thank you.
Dhanyavad. Thank you. Namaskar to all. We'll start with a prayer. Prior to that, madam, am I audible and visible?
Yes, sir. You are audible and visible. But just a second for the interruption. I request all the audience and the participants to switch off your video and please mute your audio, because most of the participants already muted. But please switch off your video if it is possible. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. So we have 40 minutes of time, correct?
Yes, sir.
Till 7:20. Okay.
Yes. Last 10 minutes, we'll take few questions from the audience if they have.
Fine. Okay. We'll start with the prayer then. Namah Shri Yati Rajaya Vivekananda Suraye सच्चित् सुख स्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे स्वामिने तापहारिणे. नमस्कार. फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट आई बो डाउन एट द ब्लेस्ड फीट ऑफ रिवर्ड स्वामी आर्यानंद जी महाराज, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ रामकृष्ण मठ एंड मिशन भुवनेश्वर, बिकॉज ऑफ विच वी आर हियर टुडे एंड हु हैज कनेक्टेड अस टुगेदर, एंड ऑल्सो द मैक ग्रुप फॉर गिविंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी to remember some of the incidences of Swamiji's life on the occasion of forthcoming birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, which falls on 12th of January. Today's topic, that is Swami Vivekananda, New Discoveries. So this topic, particular topic, is based on the book by Mary Louise Burke, that is Sister Gargi, which comes in 6 volumes. And in this particular book, she has tried to put light on the various facets of Swami Vivekananda's personality, and we'll try to see how much we can cover through the assigned time and try to understand the various facets of Swami Vivekananda's personality. As Swami Vivekananda's Guru Ramakrishna Paramahansa has said, that nobody can understand Naren fully, and that is absolutely true at the end of this particular session. probably each one of us to some extent will agree with this, that nobody can fully understand Nare. So before going into the topic, I would just like to give a brief sketch of Swami Vivekananda. And I will be doing this through a presentation. I'll try to share a presentation, and at the back of it, I will be giving the commentary. That is how we will go for the today's session. I'll just try to share my screen. Give me a moment. Is my screen visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, fine, thank you. So before going to the topic, I would just like to give a brief biographical sketch of Swami Vivekananda. He was born on 12th of January 1863 in Calcutta. Educated as per the British education system at that point of time in India. And he did excellently well in whatever aspects he did in his life. He was excellent in music, singing, in debate. He was a great orator, extremely brave, naughty, brilliant, strong. You name it, whatever skill, and he had it. And he had a great passion to know the truth. After passing through the college, as we all know, that he visited many places, many people, and asked the same question. Have you seen God? None of the people he visited could give him satisfactory answer. And finally, in the November 1881, when he met Sri Ramakrishna, he said, yes, I have seen God. And I can see it more clearly than I am seeing you. And he said, if you listen to me and if you follow what I tell you, I can also make you see God. And that was the turning point for Narendra. At that point of time was Narendra. Later he became Swami Vivekananda. So that was the turning point in Narendra's life. And then he stayed there with his guru. Almost it took 1 year to accept him as a guru. He tested his guru. Then around 5 to 6 years, he served his guru at the feet of Sri Ramakrishna. In 1886, after passing away of Sri Ramakrishna, his guru, then Swamiji traveled all over India for a few years, around 6 to 7 years. And in 1893, he went to Chicago, America, to represent Hinduism or Vedanta. He stayed there for about 3.5 years, then came back to India, then set Ramakrishna Mutt and Mission in India, again went back to West, spent about 1.5 year. So in all total, he spent about 5 years of his active life in the West. And Swamiji passed away at the age of 39 years, 5 months and 24 days. He himself professed that I shall never stay to see 40. We read biography, right? Many biographies of many people we read, but we want to know the personal side of the great people. Because Swami Vivekananda himself once said to Nivedita, as I grow older, I find greatness in small things. He said, as I grow older, I find greatness in small things, and I want to know how a great man eats, how a great man wears his clothes, how he speaks with his servants. Anyone can be great. See, Swamiji says, anyone can be great, anyone can be great at a great position. Even a coward will become a hero, or he will become a brave in the glare of floodlights. So more and more greatness seems to me that of a worm doing his job silently, steadily, from moment to moment, from hour to hour. The older I grow, there more seems to lie in manliness. This is my new gospel. So we want to know the personal life of a great soul. See, many times this happens even in our personal lives. We see great speakers, great intellectual speakers who speaks at a great length, a great oratory powers. And he charms us. many a times he charms us, many of the speakers, they do charm us, but that particular charm is of his intellectual power. That particular person may not have a great character at his home. He may not be a very good person at his home, at his family, in the society. But he at times may charm us because of his intellectual powers. So therefore, it is very important to know the personal life of a great man. See, there is a story in Ramayana when Sita was taken away by Ravana. So Rama and Lakshmana, both of them were wandering all around to look for Sita. And at the lake Pampa, when Rama and Lakshmana came, then Rama was very much sad at the loss of Sita. And he has lost his peace. And he saw a crane, majestic white crane, in that particular lake, quiet and calm. And then he says to Lakshmana, look, how majestic and peaceful that crane is. Why I don't have that peace? The moment he says say to Lakshmana, the small fish in the lake immediately says to Rama, Oh Rama, you call that particular crane peaceful, majestic? He's not peaceful at all. He has eaten my wife, he has eaten my children, and now he is meditating on me that when I will eat him. So outwardly, it looks peaceful, but its intent is not as good as it seems. So we want to know personal life. Great person is great in every sphere. Swamiji was perfect in every sphere. That's why Swamiji said, religion is manifestation of perfection already in a man. So you name it, Swamiji was perfect in it. And he translated the highest things into day-to-day lives. So topic today, as I said, is Swami Vivekananda, new discoveries. And this particular discussion, which we are now starting, we are entering into it, is based on, as I told you earlier, by Mary Louise Burke. She has done 30 years of research on the life of Swami Vivekananda. Remember, she had spent 30 long years researching on Swami Vivekananda. She went to almost all the places where Swami Vivekananda had been to the West. She visited those places, visited the libraries, visited the newspaper stores, gone through the old newspaper cuttings, met the people where Swamiji stayed, met the descendants of the families where Swamiji stayed, took their interviews, tried to do more and more research and try to find the new aspects of Swamiji's facets and personality. And it took her 30 years of her life and 6 big volumes she has produced under the name Swami Vivekananda in the West, New Discoveries. And in the very introduction of it, she says, see, absurdity of having opinion at all of Swami Vivekananda, who is so vast, personality so vast as being Swami Vivekananda itself, is an absurd. She says, having opinion itself about Swami Vivekananda is something like an absurd thing. You cannot have an opinion of a personality as big as Swami Vivekananda. Such a vast personality he had. Merely reading a couple of books by any Tom and Harry, we are not going to understand Swami Vivekananda. Probably we can understand one of the facets of Swami Vivekananda, which particular author has gone through and realize, that does not mean that Swami Vivekananda was only confined to that particular aspect. So it is very important in life, whenever we read, what do we read? Whether it is from the authentic sources. If we want to learn Swami Vivekananda, let us read Swami Vivekananda from Ramakrishna Math and Mission publications. If we read, we'll be able to understand some of the facets of Swami Vivekananda. I said some of the facets. So coming back to Mary Louise Burke, she says, her 30 years of research and 6 volumes, she says, it is like emptying the ocean with the blade of a grass. She says, what efforts I have put in to produce this volume, 6 big volumes, around 2,500 plus pages, she says, it is an effort like emptying the ocean with the blade of a grass. And if the few drops of that ocean have fallen on these pages, and it would be of some help to the devotees, she said, my effort, I will consider that has not gone into the vain. See the humbleness of her. 30 years of life spent in researching, and after researching, coming with the book, she says, it is like emptying the ocean with a blade of a grass, with few drops that ocean on these pages. If I can bring something of Swamiji to the devotees, it will be at least some work, and my efforts will not be in vain. So next 35 or 30 minutes or so, we'll be looking at very fascinating aspects of Swamiji's personal life, which probably many of us may not be knowing. We probably know about sisters and brothers in America, probably there for us Swamiji ends. But let us see his surprising, at times funny, at times simple like a child, at times like a great yogi, at times a sportsman, his cooking lessons, his drawing lessons and so on. And as much as we can squeeze through the available time, we'll just try to go through. Now this is the first, we'll start with the reminiscences of Miss Conger. The picture which you see at the left corner of your screen is Mrs. Lyon. So Mrs. Lyon is the one with whom Swamiji stayed when he was in Chicago, for when he came for the Parliament of Religions. At Mrs. Lyon's home, Swamiji was staying, and she had a granddaughter named Miss Conger. When Swamiji was staying with them, she was only 6 years old. Now see, 6 years old, and later, almost at the age of 80 plus, when she became a senior citizen, she has written her reminiscences on the insistence of Monks of Ramakrishna Math Mission. She said, even what I experienced when I was at 6 years of age, I just cannot forget, she says. And like her, many more people who have come across Swamiji at their younger age says, whosoever has met Swamiji once, he can never ever forget Swamiji in his entire life. Now this particular Miss Conger, when she was 6 years old, she wrote in her reminiscences, whenever I used to come from the school jumping, I used to come and jump onto the lap of Swamiji. He used to be at my home. I used to go and jump and sit in his lap, and I used to ask him, Swamiji, come on, tell me some stories. And Swamiji used to tell her beautiful stories about elephant, parrots, banyan trees, lion, and many more stories, interesting stories, which Swamiji used to tell for children. And Swamiji used to tell that particular stories to the children, to this particular Miss Conger, who was 6 years old. And then Swamiji would ask her, come on, Conger, show me your books. What has been taught to you in your school? And then he used to take her books, take her textbooks, and just try to go through it. And Swamiji was very much interested in the child psychology and how the child is being taught in America. And he used to see her books, and looking at the maps in the books, she said, he used to point at the pink colored map and used to say, this is India, this is my country. And suddenly his eyes seemed to brighten up. The moment he used to look at map and he used to point his finger and say, this is India, this is where I come from, this is my motherland. At the very second moment, looking at her books, Swamiji used to get a little disappointed and sad, and thinking that unfortunately this kind of education which this little American girl is getting in my own country, daughters of my country, children in my country do not have access to these kind of an education. Even in America, playing with that little child, that time Swamiji is telling her stories of monkeys, at the very second moment Swamiji is remembering the children in his own home country and worrying about how, what can I do so that children in my country will have better kind of an education like this American girl is getting. Whenever Swami used to go for lectures, he used to come, whatever money he used to get, he used to tie it in his handkerchief like a small child, and like a proud child used to come to Mrs. Lyon, and he used to put all the money tied in his handkerchief and give it to Mrs. Lyon and saying, as if ki bhai main itna sara kama ke leke aa gaya. He was indifferent to money, and he used to give it to Mrs. Lyon, and he never bothered about how much money did he get, because, and he even did not know how to count the money. Then the Miss Conger says, my grandma taught Swamiji how to count dollars and how to count cents. He was never bothered about the money. He used to just deposit with the Mrs. Lyon. Then she opened his account and used to put that money on Swamiji's account. Swamiji was never bothered for it. The other interesting incident which used to happen at a dinner table, which you see the Tabasco and pepper sauce, which you see. Swamiji was sitting at the dinner table, Conger writes, and then during the dinner, that sauce bottle, it's a paper sauce. Swamiji used to like hot chili and hot pepper sauce. As we know, Swamiji used to like hot and spicy Indian food. In Western countries, he did not have that spicy food. So this particular Tobasco sauce bottle was given to him. Swamiji took that bottle. Everybody was sitting on the dining table, opened the bottle and emptied the entire bottle into his plate, and everybody was struck. What is Swamiji doing? Entire sauce bottle. It will be too hard. It's a pepper sauce. Because those people were not habituated to use that much sauce. Swamiji emptied the entire bottle and he relished his dinner, enjoyed his dinner a lot with that particular hot sauce, which is other people sitting at the dining table were surprised to see, oh, he needs such a hot sauce. And from, she says, next day onwards, whenever Swami used to be at the dinner table, there used to be a new sauce bottle every time whenever Swamiji used to be there on the dinner table. Now think for a moment of all these different kinds, facets of his person. It's the same Swami Vivekananda who has changed the entire thought current of the world, moved the world. Same Swami Vivekananda tells stories to a six-year-old girl, does not know how to count money, likes pepper sauce, wraps money in his handkerchief and gives it to the Mrs. Lyon, grandmother, becomes sad looking at the Indian map and this education which Indian child does not get. See the various facets. Now coming to when Swamiji came to Hale House, the picture which you see at the right side of the slide is the actual Hale House which was there when Swamiji was there. Currently it is not there, it is already raised and changed. There come a new apartment has come, a hotel has come, it is not there now. It was like this. This is the actual photograph of the Hale House where Swamiji came. As we all know that Swamiji came around 2 months earlier to the, went to Chicago. Then from Chicago, we all know that he went to Boston because in Boston, cost of living was less. So he spent some time in Boston. Then from Boston, again, he came back. At Boston, he met Professor John Wright, who gave him the recommendation to appear in the Parliament of Religion. Then he came along with the recommendation letter and address of Parliament of Religion, came to Chicago. He was not habituated to have a lot of luggage and all these things. The night he spent in the railway wagon, as we all know, strange country, a stranger in a strange country with a strange wardrobe, no place to hide his head. He spent the entire chilly night in America in a railway wagon. Next day, no food, nothing in his stomach, wanted to have something, no money, luggage and everything misplaced, even the address of Parliament of Religion misplaced. So Swamiji was little disappointed, tried to went to the door and door and tried to beg there, forgetting it is America. In America, people slammed doors at his face, looking at the wardrobe which he wear, which was very much creased because he slept in a railway wagon and morning he was roaming, nothing to eat. So in a sad mood, he sat near this Hale House, in front of this particular house on the footpath, thinking that come what may, let us see, whatever happens, I leave it to my Guru Deva. He was sitting there and then the door opens from the house on the opposite side of the road, and then this is Mrs. Hill. She came and she asked, looking at his wardrobe, are you one of the delegates for this Parliament of Religion? Swamiji said yes. She took him to her home, gave him snacks. Swamiji freshened up, also helped him to go to the Parliament of Religion and register him as a delegate. And then rest, we, as we all know, it was a history that Swamiji gave this famous piece of Sisters and Brothers of America. Then this Hale House became one of his important office whenever he was in the West, when he stayed in Chicago. This particular house became his office and he loved Mrs. Hale like his mother, and also Mrs. Hale like her son, Swami Vivekananda. So when he was staying at this particular house, when he was in the West, Swamiji used to roam around and stay at this particular place. Now this is again a different aspect of Swamiji. Same Swamiji, see, world mover, gave the world conquering speech. And this is the inside photograph of this Hale House. And then again, in the reminiscences, Mrs. Mary Hale, the daughter of Mrs. Hale, has told to Swami Abhedananda. She was a young daughter at that point of time. One day, Swamiji took it to his mind. Swamiji saw roller skates. We all know roller skates, right? our kids do this roller skating. Can you imagine Swamiji learned roller skating? Yes. Swamiji took it to his mind that I want to learn roller skate, and that's all. He put on the roller skates and went on roller skating, practicing in the well-furnished and very expensively carpeted this particular hare's house for 3 days. Swamiji went on to his heart's content, went on skating, and after 3 days, after mastering this particular skill, Swamiji mastered the skill, he learned how to skate. Nobody objected to his roller skating on even the expensive carpet and all the furnishing. Nobody objected to this loving son of theirs. As I told you, Mrs. Mary Hill used to consider Swamiji as her son, and Mary Hill, which was Hill's daughter, used to consider Swamiji as their brother. Nobody objected him. 3 days Swamiji did roller skating, learned it, and Swamiji suddenly gave it up. Mary Hill, in her reminiscences, said that, and suddenly this son, this monk son of Hill's house, lost interest in roller skating and gave it up. 3 din kar diya, uske baad chhod diya. Now the same Swamiji, when he used to be there in the Hill house, now see, that was Swamiji's one aspect of personality. Now this is again another aspect of personality. Swamiji, this is the house and this is the lane which used to look earlier like this. And this is the particular park. This is called Lincoln Park, which was there at that point of time. And currently in US, this is the Lincoln Park, which currently looks like this. It was earlier like this. So, and this was a little distance from the Hale's house. So to take fresh air and to have the sun, Swamiji used to walk from this particular house and go to this particular garden and sit in this garden alone. Now, when Swamiji used to sit in this particular garden, there used to be a young woman, a young American woman, used to cross with her 5-year-old daughter, used to go through this particular garden every day. And they used to see this particular strange man with a strange wardrobe sitting in this particular garden. And they used to cross. This particular young woman used to cross with her 5-year-old daughter, and she used to go to the market. After looking at this particular strange fellow, now think of a stranger sitting in the garden and a young American woman with her 5-year-old kid. She's seeing him daily. One day she approaches to this stranger and she says, "Sir, can you do me a favor?" Swami says, "Yes. Can you please look after this, my little daughter? I wish to go to the market." Can you imagine? Swamiji said yes, and for days together, this young woman used to come with her 5-year-old daughter to this garden. Swami used to be sitting there. She used to hand over her 5-year-old daughter to Swamiji. She used to go to the market, come back, used to take her daughter and go back home. Swami Vivekananda, world mover, think for a moment of that particular scene and think what kind of a vibration Swamiji must have radiated to this particular woman, how much safe she must have thought of a stranger in a strange country with a strange wardrobe, with a strange color of a skin. She did not know her. She did not know him. He did not know her. But even then, her 5-year-old daughter, she's asking her to take care of. Think for a moment, what pure vibrations Swamiji must be radiating. How much confidence that lady must have got through even just looking at this particular fellow. He was unknown to her, but even then she used to hand over and think that greatness of that great man. Think for a moment, Swamiji taking care of a 5-year-old daughter of a lady whom she does not know. And when this particular daughter became 15 or 16 years old, till that time Swami Vivekananda has become a very, very famous personality. And when her mother One day, then she came to know. Till that time, she was not knowing it. Then the mother, one day, asked her daughter, "Do you know your old friend?" Looking at one of the newspaper clippings. Someone else is presenting screen, I think.
Yeah, yes, Rohini madam, I'm already written in the chat box. So please do not present anything. So stop presenting.
I hope my presentation is visible.
No, sir.
Oh,
it is not visible. Please, please present again, sir.
Okay. But I think there was no issue in the audio, right?
No, sir. You are perfectly audible.
Okay, fine. So we were talking about the, I'm trying to again share the screen. So we are talking about the Lincoln Park, when Swamiji was there in the Lincoln Park and how he was taking care of a little 5-year-old girl. And when that girl grew older, about 15 or 16 years of age, her mother asked, after looking at one of the photographs in the newspaper, "Do you remember this? Is my screen visible?"
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the mother asked, "Do you remember him?" And then she says, "How come I can forget?" And after 15 and 16 years, when she become old, this particular girl, you see the impressions which were made at the 5 years of age, that came up, that sprout up. And this particular girl, after the marriage, when she settled into Philadelphia, she moved to the Philadelphia ashram and she became student of Swami Akhilananda, because we are also having a Ramakrishna Math Mission Center in Philadelphia. So this particular girl's impressions made at 5 years of age. Now again, a very altogether a different aspect. Now somebody who's taking care of a 5-year-old girl, somebody who is eating a hot pepper sauce, somebody who does not know how to count money, somebody is indifferent to money, somebody is telling stories to the children. And the same Swamiji, can we imagine Swamiji wanted to row the boat? He said, "I want to learn how to boat." When Swamiji was in a swam coat in a summer resort, when he moved from New York, he moved to the summer resort. He was in a swam coat and he was in a boat. He wanted to learn the boating and he learned boating. Not only he learned boating, while rowing the boat, he also capsized the boat. While he was rowing the boat, he also capsized the boat. The same Swamiji, okay? Now the same Swamiji who capsized the boat, in his letter to Mary Hell, which is on the left corner of your screen, who is the daughter of Mrs. Hell, in which house Swamiji was staying. In one of his letters to her, Mary Hell, Swamiji writes, "I capsized the boat, okay? I capsized the boat and I drenched in water and I drenched the entire your favorite coat in water." Now Mary Hell liked one of Swamiji's coat very much. Swamiji had few coats when he went to America because of winter there, and to have the clothing like the Westerners used to have, whenever he used to have in the dyers, he had a big long cloak, long coat, and Mary Hell liked one of Swamiji's coat very much. She was very particular about that particular coat of Swamiji, and she used to say, "Brother, whenever you go for a dais, please wear this particular coat." So Swamiji knows she liked this particular coat. So Swamiji writes her in his letter, "I capsized the boat and drenched the coat which you liked." And the next sentence is very, very important. What Swamiji says, But don't worry, nothing will happen to that coat, because that particular coat is permeated with my deep meditation on the Absolute." See, the same Swamiji is learning the boating, capsizing the boating, and the very second moment is writing that don't worry about that particular coat which is drenched, because that particular coat is permeated through my deep meditation on the Absolute. See the great heights of these great personalities. And again, Swamiji, in another letter, what happened? Mary Hell and other, there were three sisters in Hell's house. There were three sisters, Mary Hell and other two McKinley sisters. with Swamiji. These three sisters, Swamiji, suppose they're as their sisters, and these three sisters taught Swamiji as their brothers. So these three sisters taught Swamiji. Swamiji was very much interested to learn languages also. So these three sisters taught Swamiji one French song. Okay, one French song. Swamiji mastered that song. And the French translation especially, they taught in a funny way, just to make fun out of him. They told him a little wrong translation. Swamiji, when he met one of his French friend, Swamiji said, "I know a little of French and I want to sing a song in French." So Swamiji sang that particular song, and that particular French man gone mad laughing. Swamiji says, because these three sisters taught Swamiji a little funny kind of a translation, a wrong transmission. So Swamiji was little disappointed and angry, and then he wrote from this Swam's Court during the summer when he was in the Swam's Court enjoying this boating and in the water, enjoying a lot of water sports. And in Chicago, it was quite hot at that point of time. So Swamiji writes, "You three particular three maids," he says, "you must be sizzling, boiling in hot summer, and I am enjoying here in the Swam's Court. You taught me wrong translation, and that's why you are suffering. In the sizzling hot Chicago summer, I am enjoying the Swam's Court. I am enjoying like a duck in the water." See what language Swamiji is funny. "I am enjoying here like a duck in the water," just to tease them how I am not hot, I am enjoying in the water. Again the same Swamiji, when he was in the Camp Percy at another location, in one of, again, letter to Mary Hill. See the sense of humor Swamiji is. He write, when Swamiji was staying with one of his student, one of his friend, student, disciple, Josephine MacLeod, Swamiji writes to Mary Hill in his one of his letter. She said, Joe, he used to say Josephine MacLeod, Joe has to pay for her sweetness. He said, Joe has to pay her for his sweetness, because there were a lot of mosquitoes and they used to attack her. But I, being a Hetan, Swamiji says, I, being a Hetan, they did not dare to bite me. And nowadays I sing a lot many songs. That's why probably these mosquitoes does not come to me. So funny thing, and humorously Swamiji writes that. Swamiji even gone to Charles' aunt. So this is a comedy show, a drama, comedy drama, which was very famous at that point of time. Swamiji even attended Charles' aunt, a comedy drama, and he says, "I almost killed myself laughing and laughing while looking at this particular Charles' aunt, particular comedy drama." Swamiji was not a dry monk. So he enjoyed this particular drama. This is again a different aspect of Swamiji's. Coming to again next. Now when Swamiji was there in Detroit. Now this is an incident. This is a reminiscence by one of a teacher named Miss Cook. She was a German teacher there, and she was not a lady with a strong proposition. Very strong-minded lady. For the first time, she heard Swamiji's lecture in Unitarian Church. Okay, and she first time in her life, she writes in her reminiscences, "In first time in my life, I thought that I must go and congratulate the speaker whom I have heard. I have never ever heard such a wonderful lecture." So she had an urge to go and shake hands with this particular lecturer. She went ahead to Swamiji and shook his hand. And then she says, when Swamiji took my hand for some moments and he looked into my eyes, and I shall never ever forget his searching and soul penetrating look. Now see what kind of a vibration Swamiji must be transmitting. Then she shook her hands, and then she says, "For next 3 days, I could not wash my hands. For next 3 days, I could not wash my hands because I do not want to go those holy vibrations, that holy touch we had received through my hand." Think for a moment what kind of a powerful vibration Swamiji must be transmitting to this unknown lady. She has never ever heard him. She has never ever met him. Her first lecture, which she heard, shook her hands with him, and 3 days she is unable to wash her hands. Think of a holy vibrations, the powerful vibrations which Swamiji must have transmitted. 3 days she could not wash her hands. Same Swamiji, when he was as same Unitarian Church Massachusetts, one of the ministers whom Swamiji were there at Lawrence, he used to teach their children, Sheila and Eleanor, small children, how to wear this particular turban which he used to wear. Those children were very much fascinated. They used to request, and Swamiji used to teach them how to wear his turban. And one of the small child in the same minister's house, Philip, Swamiji wrote, in next 1 minute we are finishing. I think my time is over. In next 1 minute we'll finish it up. To Philip, Swamiji gave this particular message in his birthday diary: do in the childhood that will help you in age. Probably message to all the children, that do in childhood that will help you in age. So these are some of the reminiscences. There are many more, but given the time, probably we have to stop here. My time is finished. So once again, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to be here and to share few of the reminiscences. As I said, Mary Louise Burke has spent 30 years of her research and then come up with the 6 volumes. And whatever incidences I have shared, it is from the same book. The purpose of this particular talk was just to understand that merely going through one or couple of books and thinking that we have understood Swamiji is not going to help us. And again, I repeat, as Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa said, nobody can understand Naren fully. So understanding Swamiji is a life's work. So probably even in this life, if we can understand S of Swami Vivekananda, I think our lives will be worth of it. If we can understand S of it and implement part of it, that will be a great service to the nation, to the society, and to ourselves. So once again, I thank you very much for MAC group, and also Bo at the feet of revered Swami Aryanandaji Maharaj. Because of whom we could get connected. Thank you very much. Dhanyavaad. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful presentation and insight on the different facets of Swami Vivekananda. So now, this forum is open for the audience to ask few questions if you have in your mind. If you have any questions, you can write in the chat box or you can unmute and ask. So if you have any questions. Do anybody having any questions or anything you want to say? If you want to ask the speaker, you can ask or write in the chat box.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Uthal speaking. Actually, I want to Mahesh. Is he worked in Saudi?
Yeah, Abhimanyu, I have seen you, and we'll talk after this presentation. After so many years, I could see you.
Okay. Yeah. Because I forget mobile number. Yes, I don't have a chip. So this mobile number, we'll talk. Okay, nice.
Thank you. Sir, there is a question in the chat box from Pramod Kumar, that what is the message you want to give to the senior citizens?
Yeah, message to the senior citizen. There is a wonderful book by Swami Ranganathanji Maharaj, Bliss in Old Age. It's a small book, Bliss in Old Age, How to Attain Bliss in Old Age. If you can go through that book, you will find beautiful ideas especially for senior citizens to dwell on. I think senior citizen life, as we know that there are four ashramas, and the senior citizen which comes at the last, and the probably one of the best thing, because we have already gone through the household duties and responsibilities. It is all now gone, and now gone through. Now at least at this particular age, we should try to strive for and to attain God. See, the purpose of life is God realization. How I can become better, better and better every passing day, that should be searched for, which we should go on doing and do our self-study, read more and more, read literature of Swami Vivekananda, and continue to do your sadhana, whatever the best possible sadhana, and try to serve the people who are less privileged than us. That is the one of the main messages of Swami Vivekananda. Service to man is service to God. So if we can serve the people who are less privileged than us, help could be in any terms. It could be financial help, it could be intellectual help, it could be any help, whatever you have surplus from you. It could be giving time to somebody. We can do that and try to serve people whatever possible way we can. And I think that will help us to grow personally also and spiritually also.
Thank you, sirs. Anybody else having any questions or anything you want to ask, sir? It seems the participants have no questions. So I hope everyone enjoyed the talk of sir, because he has explained many facets which we might not have known. And because as he rightly said that nobody can understand Swami Vivekananda fully. And I do believe in that, because he's such a legend, it's very difficult to understand the person. And one thing we can do that as different books are there, so different messages Swami Vivekananda as he has given. And one thing which always tossed my heart and always I do practice is that arise, awaken and never give up. So we are really happy for the insightful talk on Swami Vivekananda. So any other question, or I'll wind up? Any other questions from the audience, or I'll wind up the session?
Madam, may I want to refer some books?
Yes, sir, definitely, sir.
I would request every one of you to please, those who have not gone through, to please read Swami Vivekananda's biography by Swami Nikhilananda, which will be available at Ramakrishna Mutt and Mission Centers, if it is there in your city. Lectures from,
yes, sir, it is there.
Yeah, lectures from Colombo to Almora, Letters of Swami Vivekananda, and My India, India Eternal. So these are the minimum books I recommend everybody, every national from this particular country must at least these, I am telling, read a biography of Swami Vivekananda by Swami Nikhilananda. Again, I said, what we read about Swami Vivekananda, please read authentic books. As I told you earlier, the whole purpose of this particular talk was that try to understand Swamiji in the right light, in the right perspective. My India, India Eternal by Swami Vivekananda, lectures from Colombo to Almora, Swami Vivekananda, and again, letters of Swami Vivekananda. Thank you very much. And for the senior citizens, I'll once again repeat, Bliss in Old Age by Swami Ranganathananji Maharaj. Thank you. Dhanyavad.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So now let me wind up the webinar, because we are on time. So on behalf of MAC Group of Institutions, the Secretary of Manav Adhyayan Kendra, Ms. Kirti Das, Principal Advisor Dr. Haraprasanna Das, and our Chairman Mr. R.K. Sutar, and Vice Chairman Sanjukta Patnaik, and the whole team of Manav Adhyayan Kendra, I, Dr. Malavika, thanks, extends my gratitude from the core of my heart to Sir Mahesh Sandeepan Gaikwad, sir, for giving the excellent speech and enlightening us with different insights on Swami Vivekananda. So we are really grateful to you, sir, for your time and giving the speech. And I also extend my gratitude to all the audience. In spite of being a Sunday, you all of you joined, and also there are 29 participants till the end. So I am really thankful and grateful. I extend my gratitude and thanks to all the audience present here. And thank you once again. Namaskar. So once again, namaskar to everyone. Thank you. So let's close the